Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thanks for joining me once again. So I'm back with another tarot reading and this is your March prediction. I know I'm a little bit late with it, but you know what? Better late than never. And this way you will also be able to see if the group that you chose started already resonating with you for the month of March, because I'll be reading the energy of your month of March. And before you guys are going to choose one of the groups, I want to announce the winner of the giveaway of the February prediction. This is a winner that can claim a free tarot reading with me. Please leave a comment down below, let me know you're here, and I'm gonna tell you how to claim your prize. And if you would like to win, have a chance to win a free tarot reading, all you gotta do is just watch your March prediction and then let me know in the comments how you feel about March and also how your month of February went. So you can literally start your sentence with "my February was dot dot dot." And then in April prediction video, I will announce the winner of that reading. So make sure to subscribe and turn on the notifications. All right, guys. So now I want you to intuitively choose one of the groups. We have group one, group two, and group three. Whichever you feel the most drawn to, that is going to be your reading. All the timestamps are in the description box, so look for it, click on it, and then I'll see you in your reading. And I'm gonna start with group number one. Hi, group one. So you guys chose this card, and this card is creativity. So your month is revolving around creative energy. Awesome. I feel like in general, this month, you are going to feel more creative and you're going to find creative solutions to your problems. That's what I'm hearing. So things that maybe kept you stuck, maybe kept you postponing some things, like things that were blocking your way for any reason. I think this month, during the month of March, you're going to find a solution, a creative solution to make this, to kind of push this energy, to make something out of it. If you guys are in a creative industry, if you do any kind of creative work for a living, I feel like your creativity is just kind of like highlighted and you have more ideas. You have more creative ideas. Another message that I'm getting is for you to act on that creativity. So if you're going to have some, you know, sudden spark of inspiration, the spirit wants you to act on that idea for a reason. So at least write it down. Just don't push it away. I feel like eventually it would come back, but in general, treat all your ideas, like pay attention to them and do something with it, especially during the month of March. I also pulled another card for you, which is love. So this month is also revolving around love, romantic love, platonic love, but I feel like mostly romantic for you guys. Let's put this here. Romantic love. So if you are in a relationship, you guys might be just spending a lot of maybe romantic time together or just quality time together. If you're single, it's very possible that, well, someone new is coming in or you're flirting with someone. There's someone popping in and this person is kind of like just taking your time, right? Taking your time, living in your head, taking space in your head. That's how I'm feeling. There's a big focus on love, on, I feel like, especially romantic love this month. Whatever is happening, love is around you. All right. I'm also getting this energy of like clearing the space or cleansing, because I have yellow and blue, and these two colors reminded me of like something fresh coming in. So I feel like you are pretty much focused on cleansing the energy around you, maybe even on cleaning in depth, like your house in depth, doing some in-depth cleaning or like deeper cleaning. That's how it feels in different like areas of your life. I think this is going to give you like a fresh page to start over. It's going to make you feel more inspired, motivated, and even creative. So your tarot cards are Three of Swords reversed. So with this card, there might be a couple of different like outcomes. The first thing that came to my mind is old wounds coming back. This could be read as someone from your past returning into your life, someone that you kind of were hurting over, someone that caused you some pain, some inconvenience at least. So old wounds reopening, kind of possibly exes coming back. But the other way that this card could be read is finally kind of healing these wounds, healing the wounds that were caused by somebody else. We also have Seven of Swords reversed. Yeah, so someone that did you nasty for sure. This energy here together, someone that did you nasty somehow appears again in your life during this month. Let's see. But we have also Nine of Wands, so you are very defensive about it. So it doesn't matter that this person... Apologies. So it doesn't matter that this person... Oh my god, I'm so glad that the phone is still, you know, attached. Oh my god, imagine if it just fell. Okay. Sorry. But with the Nine of Wands, yes, you're defensive. So it doesn't matter that this person is coming, because I feel like you're not going to fully kind of like let them in. You are still thinking what you were thinking at the time when you guys were probably going separate ways. I just feel like you stand on your own ground. You're not going to change your mind just because this person pops in again. Just because this person is around you. But in general, I'm feeling very defensive energy due to something that happened, the old wound kind of coming back, resurfacing, an ex coming back. Like, it just feels like it's someone that you realized after what they've done that you can't trust, so you're very defensive about it. Okay. Let's pull a few more. So we also have Two of Swords, which is a card of choice. So there is a big decision for you guys to make this month. And I think that you're still trying to figure it out. And I even feel like you're working really hard to figure it out, to figure out what to do. This might have to do with literally your job. But either way, with the Death reversed, you see this month, or you realize this month, that you will have to make some decision, and that you will have to kind of make a transition that you are not very excited about or you don't find convenient. I do think that you see that at the end of the day, this is going to serve you well, because that's what the Death is usually. The Death is about this change that we have to go through. And when it's in reverse, I always read this as... not wanting to go through this change because it's uncomfortable. Like, we're afraid of a change. A lot of people don't like when things are changing, because we have to kind of start learning again from, you know, point zero. We are in environment that we just don't know, that we don't feel comfortable in. So I do think that this month you realize that it's time to make this decision. You're getting closer to realizing, or like understanding what to do in this situation, working hard to bring some sort of solution and kind of get, what's the word for it, you're getting settled, you're getting let me shuffle the cards and think about that word that I'm missing right now. Oh, a card fell. Okay, if I remember, I'll tell you later. All in the golden afternoon. Inspiration, creative spark, imagination, and conception. But yeah, going back to this, it's just like you're getting adjusted. You're getting settled. You are getting even adjusted to this idea. getting kind of to know this new like way of living or whatever it is, whatever transition you guys have to go through. But going back to this card, we have all in golden afternoon, inspiration, creative spark, imagination, and conception. So this is your advice of the month. And it's actually number one, which is representing a new start. So something new might be beginning for you guys this month. Let's read what it says. Time to create an imaginative idea. Inspiration takes hold. Talent and ability. The muse touches down in your life. Get ready. Ooh, nice. Okay, so let's see. Okay, this card represents a time immediately before Alice's existence. There's no rabbit hole, no cat, no Mad Hatter, no Queen of Hearts. There's only the urge to tell a story. So it is with you at this moment. A spark of inspiration is about to descend upon you. Amazing. This is like literally your first card and the card that you guys chose. A wondrous tale is asking to be told through you. This surge of imagination can take many forms. It can be a creative solution to a problem. Like, I'm not even kidding. Look, creative solution to a problem you're experiencing. It may mean using visualization to improve at a physical activity or painting a picture with a new technique or a fresh perspective. Whatever form it takes, you are actively telling a story of your life with every word you speak and creating the story and action with every move you make. What wonderlands can you create when you allow yourself to be open to the genius all about you and invite it to come into the world through you? You are imaginative, you are creative, you have the spark within you. Whatever it is you wish to do, paint, draw, sing, write, dance, do this creative, vital, brilliant, life-bringing thing. Who knows what creations you can bring forth? Why not begin to discover the possibilities today? Ooh, amazing. So there is definitely, I'm showing it to you if you guys want to like pause and read again. So there's definitely this big focus on the creativity this month. So follow this creative spark. It's going to take you places for sure. It might even help you to make the decision, with making the decision that you guys have to make. And yeah, the spirit is also again reminding you of these old wounds that might be resurfacing. Is that how you say it? Resurfacing this month. Stand your ground. You know what's best for you. Don't let this person to just change your mind. All right, so thanks guys for joining, watching this reading. Hope this somehow resonates already with your month of March. Let me know in the comments how you feel about all of this. And thanks again for watching. Don't forget you can book a personal reading with me. And I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye. Group two. Let's see what card you guys chose. So we have teaching and learning. All right, so the month of March is all about teaching and learning. So there's a lot of learning that you guys will do. There are a lot of lessons that will be learned this month. Lessons that will probably help you a lot throughout this year. That's how I'm feeling. But also, this could be literally referring to you teaching something. This could be you teaching a course or teaching something, teaching someone else something, maybe at work or your friend. I feel like whatever wisdom that you're sharing, it makes huge, or it impacts other people's life hugely this month. So even if you guys are not like literally teachers or mentors or gurus or any kind of teachers, you know, coaches, etc., even if you don't have any kind of job like that, I feel like it's just the wisdom that you're sharing with a friend, with your partner, with your family, with your mother, with someone. I feel like it's going to impact them really hugely. So the message from the spirit is to say what's on your heart, say what you think, what is your truth, basically. Don't be afraid of sharing it, of speaking it, of talking about it. All right, that's how I feel. That's how I feel that That's the message for you guys. I'm going to shuffle the cards. I'm going to get one more card and just think about this card for a second. Yeah, but also this learning. You're learning a lot this month. So if you guys are maybe attending some sort of course or class, I do feel like the spirit wants you to be more in the moment and be more like embracing that energy more and being open to it more, or being even more open to other people's advice. I'm not saying that you have to immediately act on it, but kind of listen to it at least. Sometimes we feel like, or we think that we actually are open-minded and we do listen to other people's advice, but very often we don't. Very often we just pretend to be listening, or very often we, even when we have a conversation, we don't really listen to what other person is saying. We're immediately thinking about how to respond. I feel like that happens for a lot of people. This happens sometimes to me too, but I'm trying to pay attention to like the conversation, to what that person is saying, and not really thinking about that. But yeah, that's the message that's coming through. So another card for you for this month is financial discipline. Okay, so maybe this is about just learning how to save up, learning how to just not spend all the money that you get, you know, maybe not spend right after you get the money, make some savings, think about the things that you actually want to save up for and start doing so. Being more financially, just in general, disciplined this month. So taking action towards that, doing something about that. Maybe it's something that you guys already have been thinking about and already are doing. Let's see. Maybe it's something that you guys are actually going to be teaching. All right. So your tarot cards are King of Cups. Okay. So I see you being very emotionally mature this month. I see this as you giving really mature advice on love or like emotions or feelings, or because that's what the King of Cups is about. He's a master of emotions, of feelings, of love as well. So I just feel like you're giving someone really good advice and you're very emotionally, as I was saying, mature. You're like, how do I say it? You have this very mature approach. I'm seeing you, just as an example, what I'm seeing in my head, like someone arguing, you know, and you being the more mature one, the person that is not going to actually have the outburst, even though the other person might have the outburst, might behave really irrationally and might later on regret it. You're very mature, like you have a very mature approach to some sort of maybe situation that might be happening. Okay, we also have Five of Coins. Yeah, so here is this financial discipline. This is where it might come from. The Five of Coins often talks about just, well, needing the financial discipline, because money is, might not be, how do I say it? You might need more money than you actually have. Something about that. Maybe it's about just you spending, or you needing to pay for something big this month, or the next few months. And I don't want to say it, but there is some issue if it comes to your finances this month. And while I was saying it, the candle went out. So it just feels like something is ending. You know, maybe you spend all your savings last month, so this month you're just not feeling so financially secure, and it's time to bring a new plan in, bring a new financial discipline in. How it feels. Okay, so we also have the Ten of Coins reverse. Interesting. Ten of Coins. So this is Ten of Coins in general. It's the card of longevity and thinking big and thinking about long-term things, future, etc., having like this long-term plan. With this being in reverse, I often see this as being like playing for now, for what's happening right now, for what's happening this month. This kind of reminded me of living kind of month by month, you know, the salary, having the salary month by month and living from one salary to another salary. There's nothing wrong with that. I feel like a lot of people live like that. And, you know, it's tough. And I just feel like this month might be one of these months for you. But with this is also about, as I said, playing for like right now, doing the things, like whatever you guys are going to be doing this month, I feel like you should do it. Thinking about short-term future, or I'm sorry, I'm not sure how to say that in English. Like, not thinking about the next, what's going to happen in the next year, but thinking rather than that, thinking about next month or next 2 months. Not looking so much into the future, but into what's about to happen soon. I think that this is what you're doing this month and what you're focusing on this month. Let's see. Let's pull a few more. March. We also have the Wheel of Fortune. Okay, so some things definitely are going to go well. this is like golden ticket, golden opportunity. So something good, really good is coming your way. It's like a strike of luck. I hope you can't hear my dog because he's snoring right now. It's really late here. And we also have Six of Coins. So you know how I see this? I see this as someone that you lent the money to, someone that borrowed money or borrowed something and is not giving back. So there might be some issue with that. This also could be some issue with paperwork. That's how I often see this too. So if you were meant to sign some sort of forms, papers, documents, you know, invoices, whatever, I see this as a problem with that. There's some issue with that. It just feels like you did your part, but someone else didn't. Okay. So let's see what is the advice for you for this month. Group two. Advice for group two for March. Advice for group two for March. So we have the right way. Learning to create what you desire. Okay, so this month you guys are teaching, learning, okay. In financial discipline, I feel like this really goes well together. You are figuring out like what you want in your financial life with teaching and learning. Maybe you're learning something new and you're figuring out like how do you want to apply this knowledge the right way. Learning to create what you desire. Figuring out what's the next step for you. Again, you know, with the 10 of coins reverse, not thinking about like, what do I want a year from now, 5 years from now, more like, what do I want this year? What do I want to achieve this year? What kind of way do I want to go this year. Okay, so let's see what it says. Okay. So this says, with the short summary, first of all, wanting to get through to the other side of a situation, a desire to walk through a gateway or a life transition to become an insider rather than remaining on the periphery. Wanting to have an impact, to be included, to be a part of activities and have an influence on the world. A willingness to learn step by step. Step by step. Okay, so what else? The Frog Food Man really does get to the heart of things. When we are pondering how to make a life dream happen or how we are to get in, through, or to the other side of whatever issue is facing us, we might wonder if we are meant to get in at all, as the Frog Foodman puts it. We can spend a great deal of time pondering our destiny, wondering if something is meant for us, and sometimes giving it up to fate, proclaiming if it is, it's meant to be, as it is meant to be. Alice has a different approach. She doesn't ask if it is meant to be. She asks how it will be done. This practical approach may not seem so spiritual to some. Are we not meant to go with the flow and see where life takes us? Here, Alice knows what must be done and sets out to discover how to achieve it. When this card comes to you, this is just what you must do. So kind of taking the matter into your own hands. Do not wonder if something is meant for you, nor leave it in the hands of gods. Instead, think of how it can be done. What practical steps can you take? How can you approach the problem in order to solve it? What action can be taken and what advice can you seek? There's always a way through the other side, but passively waiting and waiting and waiting for it to simply swing open is not as powerful as actively figuring out the puzzle and discovering how you are to reach to the other side. So ask questions, seek advice, look again from a different angle, think of the how. Wow, really powerful advice for you, Gratu. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this reading. If you did, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to the channel. Let me know in the comments how you feel about all of this. Don't forget, you can book a personal reading with me. The link is in the description box. And thanks again for watching. I'll see you in my next one. Bye. My group three. Okay, so let's see your card. Your message of the month, your theme of the month is abundance. Love that. 8-8. You guys might be seeing a lot of eight, repetitive number eight throughout this month. It is signifying abundance coming into your life. Some of you feel like might be changing your jobs, getting a raise. But if that's not it, well, in general, there's a lot of abundance around you this month. This is going to be a good month. That's how it feels, especially financially. Yeah, I feel like you guys are going to be able to get some of the things that you wanted to get, maybe the clothes that you wanted to buy, jewelry, whatever it is for you, whatever you wanted to purchase, whatever you've been maybe dreaming about, maybe saving up for a long time. But in general, there's also like extra cash coming in. You might be even finding like some coins on the ground. Just a lot of abundance in general this month. We also have a card for you, individuality, which is number 11. So you, oh my God, group three. You are in such alignment this month with 8-8, with 1-1. This is another number, angel number that you might be seeing, repetitive ones, which is representing often something new coming in, but also this is representing being in alignment with either your dream life, with your true self, with your true path, being in a flow. And when we are in a flow, good things are coming our way because we're just naturally magnetizing, attracting things that we desire. So, individuality. Okay. You're very focused this month on yourself and what you want to do. I'm even hearing on polishing your style, your brand, or like literally your style. But especially this alignment that comes to my mind, just feeling like you're in a flow. This is a good month, group three. Let's see. Main cards for my group three. What's going on for group three in March? All right, so we have 10 of Cups, which is a card of family. So you guys might be spending a lot of time with your family, reuniting with your family this month. Yeah, especially this theme of reuniting. Maybe you haven't seen your family for a while now. You'll be able to take some time off or have a really nice weekend with them. We also have the King of Cups. This could be representing a romantic partner, either that is in your life this month or already is in your life in general. If so, I see you guys spending a lot of time together, becoming even closer. there might be something happening, significant happening. I'm even seeing vacation for some of you, like taking some time off, spending a lot of time together. If you're single, this is representing someone really emotionally mature, possibly a water sign that is coming into your life, that is somehow playing a big role in your life this month. This also could be connected with maybe a boss that is giving you a raise. Someone is very generous with you. And I feel like in general, this month, people are going to be really nice to you, really generous with you. So let's see what else we have. Growth 3, what's coming in the month of March. So we have, what is this? 6 of Wands. Wow. Guys, this is a major success. This month, you guys are achieving some big success. This is literally a card of victory, of leadership, of success, once again, of being in the spotlight. So maybe your work is somehow highlighted. People are seeing you. People are appreciating you, congratulating you. Oh my God. Again, 9 of Cups. This is a card of your wishes coming true. So that's great. So that's great. I'm just thinking like, what else should I say here? Because this is a big win. It just feels like a major win for you guys this month. Major win. We also have 2 of Cups, which is a card of soulmates. So this could be connected with your romantic partner, possible romantic partner, finding that person. For some of you, I feel like it could be engagement or wedding or like something that you wanted. Something that you wanted that is going to bring you closer together. 2 of Cups, for those of you that don't care about love, you know, which is fine. But I feel like the 2 of Cups could also be representing something that you love doing. Something, again, that you are kind of like aligned to. And you are doing that this month. It's like if you wanted to maybe have a particular job or work at a particular project, take care of something. Maybe you didn't even know that you wanted it, but you get it. And then you're like, wow, this is actually what I was meant to do. You feel very aligned with something. Wow. Okay. Period. I don't know if I should pull any other cards for you guys. You also got the Magician, which is a manifester. Yes, master manifester. So you guys are manifesting something. This is also representing having a really big talent at something. And I feel like you're showcasing your skill this month. That's why we have this victory, success, but also people looking up to you and congratulating you. So the spirit is trying to say here that you have everything that you need in order to succeed at whatever it is that you're trying to succeed this month. So take this as a message of definitely encouragement to, you know, motivate yourself. Because you are really prepared with the Magician. You already have everything that you need. You are really talented at whatever you guys do, whatever you're maybe, you know, positions that you're trying to get, or, you know, it's going to be different for everyone. But with the Magician, the message here is that either you're going to get it, you're really good at it, you're naturally talented, you're also a really great communicator, and you're going to communicate your message really well. So don't worry that you're going to like mess something up, because you are not. You're really prepared, really prepared. Okay, so one card that is going to be your advice for the month is do not drink the poison. Do not do things you know are bad for you. Okay, so this could be this self-sabotage. You know, something is bad for you, but you still do it. And then you might regret it. Okay, so let's see what it says in the guidebook for this card. Divination. Avoid toxic situations, people, or relationships. Do not partake in what you know is not best for you. Ending harmful relationships, changing toxic habits, or improving your nutrition and health regime. A clean out from your home and pantry of substances, foods, even fabrics that can poison your personal environment. Changing unhealthy, harmful thoughts and beliefs about yourself and refusing to speak ill of others, choosing to encourage, support, and lead through kindness and strength. I don't know why I thought of Selena Gomez. Maybe you guys are big fans or something. Let's see. You deserve to treat yourself well. You deserve to inhibit what is not good for you. You do not need to try what is bad for you to know that it's not good for you. That it is not good for you. I'm sorry, I can't read. Let me read that again. You do not need to try what is bad for you to know that it is not for you. So when this card comes, Wonderland is advising you to no longer do what is not in your best interest. You have a habit or two that you would do well to let go of. You have people in your life that you keep giving time and space to, despite knowing you will suffer afterwards, that you will again be upset and disturbed by their harshness, their unkindness. Poison does not only come in bottles. It comes in the form of others who hurt us deliberately or even without their knowledge. It can simply be that they are not for you and you are not for them. Poison comes in the form of words which hurt and harm that fall from your lips or which are spoken about you by others. There are situations you know may hurt or endanger you. There are substances which could be toxic for you and you do not need to have them in your life anymore. When this card comes to you, it is time to eradicate that which can poison you at last. It is not cruel to refuse to hurt yourself. You will be astonished at the energy you will have once you remove these toxins from your life. Ooh, damn. Okay, tough message, but good message as well. Good advice. So thank you guys so much for watching this group 3. I hope you are going to have a fantastic month of March. Looks like you will. So congrats. And let me know in the comments how you feel about all of this. You can also enter that giveaway that I was talking about at the beginning of the reading. And leave a like. Subscribe, guys, if you haven't yet. It supports me a lot. Lets me know that you guys want to see more videos like this one. Don't forget that you can book a personal reading with me. The link is in the description box. And I'll see you guys in my next one. Have a wonderful rest of the day. Take care. Bye.